shows are gone.
CBS Ballard has been on the air less than usual. In the absence of all these hosts, some people wondering if there's more than just an isolated series of cases going on.
Sad to see her go, just like Alex Wagner before her. But I'm even sadder because I don't think these are isolated cases. Anchorman Jose Diaz-Balart is another voice that seems to be disappearing from English language airwaves.
Now you notice that graphic there that says NBC so white. Washington Post reporter Paul Fari has looked into this, and his story asked, is MSNBC so white, using the hashtag that's been trending on Twitter earlier in the week. He wrote that the departure of Melissa Harris-Perry raises the issue. Paul is back with me now, along with Kelly McBride, a pointer. Paul, sum up your reporting for us. The issue here is complicated. Melissa Harris-Perry, she had a beloved show on the air for 4 years. MSNBC gave her a platform. They also took it away, it seems like. It was marginalized, and then after she spoke up about it, her show is now officially canceled. Tell us what your reporting has found about this.
Well, MSNBC has made a big change in its orientation. It's going to cover politics full-time, just like CNN and Fox is doing. It has downplayed the talk shows, the discussion shows, like Melissa Harris-Perry's. And so in that transition, it has rearranged its schedule. It got rid of Al Sharpton. It got rid of other daily shows that were not working particularly well in the ratings for more newsy coverage. And Melissa Harris-Perry was one of the casualties of this.
Kelly, this is part of a broader issue, right, about diversity in media, is it not?
Oh, absolutely. And part of the problem is that the media, all of us, have done a bad job with diversity in general. And so then, when you make programmatic changes, like Paul is describing, and those changes happen to affect some of the only people of color that you've brought on the air, people jump to conclusions. And sometimes those conclusions are merited.
This is CNN Breaking News.
I'm Wolf Blitzer in Flint, Michigan. We are very sad to report breaking news right now. Nancy Reagan, former First Lady of the United States, has passed away. Very sad moment for all of us, especially those of us who covered Nancy Reagan so many of those years, those wonderful years when her husband was President of the United States. Nancy Reagan has passed away at the age of 90.
National convention to share her family's pain at a new cause.
We learned as too many
but they push against them, and ISIS, you know, is TTP.
As each day brings another reminder of this very long goodbye.
So Nancy, let me say thank you for all you do, thank you for you, and thank you for just being you.
She stayed put.
And osteoarthritis, which affects currently 50 million Americans.
John, good morning to you. I just wonder if you could tell us just a little bit more about the influence she had within the Republican Party.
Fuck.
I mean, my dad is rewired in a certain way. I shouldn't say rewired, but, you know, I learned a lot through that. And I was...
She wouldn't pick you up when you're down.
For me in eternity, my spirit's...
And I can honestly say,
local religious leaders crediting a News 12 investigation, playing with fire, with creating awareness.
The fact that you made a lot of noise about this, and a little bit, you were educated.
But here's the bad news. For the first time, parochial schools made the list. 5 of them.
This hasn't expired a month ago.
Okay.
Support this PBS station right now by calling or visiting us online. And thank you.
Our sustainer giving program is designed to make your life.
Question number 3. In October of 1966, in Oakland, California, Huey Newton and Bobby Seale founded.
Number 2.
What is the Black Panthers of self-defense?
Yes, that is correct. Question number 4. The first African slaves arrived in which colony?
Number 2.
What is Virginia?
That is correct.
Chris, the adoration that the
they had for each other.
Congratulations, sir.